Hey everybody, and welcome back to 7-Minute AE Tutorials. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to make these simple, yet effective, push-in and pull-out transitions. We'll be using one layer and saving them as animation presets, so you can add these to your library of transitions and bring them in with just the click of a button. And you'll get a ton of tips, tricks, and shortcuts along the way. Now before we get moving, please remember to like, share, subscribe, and consider donating to help keep this channel alive. You can buy a template, shirt, mug, learn all about shape layers on Udemy, or just be a super generous patron for the love of all things After Effects. You can also join for just $5 a month and get instant access to all of my project files, animation presets, and templates. Links for everything are in the description below. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so we have some footage here that we want to transition from into. We're going to have the city footage, and we want to zoom into one of these windows and find our hacker hard at work inside of his office here. And then we also want to do a pull out where we start on our hacker guy doing what he does and then pull out to our cityscape. So let's go ahead and get started on this. First, let's put our playhead at your cut point between these two clips. Then I'm going to shift page up twice to go backwards 20 frames. Then if you command Alt Y, you can create an adjustment layer. And I'm just going to press return to rename this layer to push in. To trim this layer to where my playhead is, I'm going to Alt left bracket. And then we're going to jump forward 40 frames. So shift page down 4 times. And then we want to Alt right bracket to trim our layer to that point. Okay, and if you press I, it will jump to the beginning of your layer. And let's go to our effects and presets and just type in transform. Double click that to add it. And we'll be affecting the scale of this layer. So let's put a keyframe for scale at the beginning of this adjustment layer. Just select the second clip and hit I. It will go to the beginning of that layer and then just page up once to go back one frame. Okay, so now let's increase our scale up to 250. So we're going to be scaling from 100 to 250 and then page down to go forward one frame. Reset our scale to 40. So our next clip is going to be super small. And then if you hit O, it will jump to the end of your layer and increase our scale to 100. So we basically have two scales going on here. We go from 100 to 250, and then from 40 to 100. But the important thing to remember here is that you want your scale at the beginning and end of your adjustment layer to equal 100. Okay, and let's select the first and last keyframes in F9 to make those easy ease. Now select this first keyframe, go into our graph editor, and pull that handle all the way right. And then we want to grab that last keyframe and pull that handle all the way left, just like that. So it starts off slow and then comes in fast. Okay, and notice we have all of this black transparency around this second clip. We can fix that right now with the motion tile. So type in motion tile, double click, select mirror edges, and change your output height and width to 250. Now you notice when you do this, you get no change. The reason why is because motion tile has to go at the top of your stack of effects. Once we do that, we can see the effect that has. When we watch that playback, you can see that kind of mosaic look is almost hidden, but we want to hide it even better. So let's go over to our effects and presets and type in CC Radial for CC Radial Blur. Double click that. Let's just close some of this up so we can focus on our radial blur. Let's change our type from scratch, that's the default setting, to fading zoom. Now make sure you're at the very beginning of your layer and let's put a keyframe for amount at 0. If we press U 2 times, it will reveal all of our keyframes, including this new one. If you press O, it will jump to the end of your layer. Add another keyframe again for 0 for amount. Now we want to go right to where this cut happens and we want to increase our amount on our radial blur to 150. And as you can see, this is really going to hide that mosaic kind of look that was created using the motion tile because that second clip is so small. So now let's select all of these keyframes in F9 to make those easy ease. And we're going to go back into our graph editor and we're going to do a similar kind of shape on these keyframes. So that left keyframe goes all the way right, the right keyframe, the handle goes all the way left. So that way it gives you a consistent look and feel. And you can adjust these values on the transform. See, like right now I have mine where it animates the second clip in from 40% up to 100%. But say if I want to go even smaller, maybe down to 30%, this will make our zoom in come in a lot faster. We notice that our motion tile now doesn't cover our entire screen. So if you do adjust these values, just keep in mind that you may have to adjust your motion tile. So if we open that back up, we can see that we're at 250 for output width and height. Let's just increase that a little bit. And as you can see, even 300 isn't quite enough. So let's try 350, and that fills it out just fine. We can watch that play back, and our zoom in comes in a lot faster. Okay, now let's add one more effect to finish this look off. Go to your effects and presets and type in exposure. Let's double click to add that. And again, let's close some of this up so that way we can focus on exposure. Make sure you're at the beginning of the layer. Put a keyframe at the beginning for zero. Press U twice to reveal all of your keyframes, including the exposure keyframes. Press O to go to the end of the layer and add another keyframe for zero. Now, if we go right to where this cut happens, we can increase our exposure up to 5. And again, we're going to select all these keyframes, F9 to make those easy ease. And we're going to do the same thing that we did for our CC radial blur. We're going to pull that left handle all the way to the right and the right handle all the way to the left. And it's really important for all these keyframes that they have the same kind of shape. So that way it moves together in a more cohesive kind of way. So now if we watch that playback, you can see now we have a really cool push in on just this one adjustment layer. Okay, now I'm going to copy this layer and I'll go over to my other comp that says pull out. Let's go to our cut point and just control V to paste that. Now the keyframes that we need to affect are these transform keyframes at the very top. So we can select all of those, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. So now our movement pulls out on both our hacker and back out to the cityscape. Okay, and let's say this as an animation preset. So let's go back in to push in and you just want to select our adjustment layer and press E to reveal all of the effects. Select all of these effects. And now there are a few ways you can save animation presets. The first is over at the effects and presets panel. There's this little icon. If you hover over it, it says create new animation preset. So you can click that and you want to drop these into your documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm in 2023, user presets. Now I have a folder for 7-minute AE. You can drop these in anywhere. You can create folders and it will be reflected in your effects and presets panel. So I'm going to drop mine into my 7-minute AE folder. And I'm just going to call this transition underscore push in. Click save. And now let's go over to our pull out and we're going to do the same thing. Just select the layer, press E to reveal all of our effects. We want to select all of those effects. And now the other way to save an animation preset is to go up to your menu bar, select animation, save animation preset. So it does exactly the same thing. And whenever you're saving more than one animation preset, it will bring you to the last place you just saved an animation preset to. As you can see, we're in 7-minute AE. So I'm going to call this one transition pull out. And now I like to always make sure my animation presets save correctly. So I'm going to delete that adjustment layer, go back to push in, delete that adjustment layer. Let's go to our cut point. Shift page up twice because whenever you're bringing in presets that have keyframes, once you add the preset, it will drop your first keyframe wherever your playhead is. So you want your playhead to be where you want the first keyframe to be dropped. Go over to effects and presets. Let's clear this out and go down to our user presets. Remember, I put mine in my 7-minute AE folder. We can open that up and there we see transition push in. I'm just going to double click that. And as you can see, it comes in on a solid, not an adjustment layer. So whenever you save effects onto adjustment layers, they will come back in on solids, but you can make any solid an adjustment layer. And I'll show you how in just a second. First, let's select U to reveal our keyframes, Alt left bracket to trim this up to that keyframe. Go down to the last set of keyframes, Alt right bracket to trim that. There's a button you can press to turn this solid into an adjustment layer. It's right here. So once you select that, your solid now becomes an adjustment layer. Okay, let's go to our pull out comp. And we want to put our playhead at the cut point, shift page up twice to go backwards 20 frames, go up to our effects and presets and double click transition, pull out. Press U to bring up our keyframes, Alt left bracket to trim to our animation in, go to the last set of keyframes, Alt right bracket to trim to those keyframes. And again, I'm going to select my create adjustment layer icon. And just like that, our solid is now an adjustment layer. So now you can save these animation presets to your own transition library and bring them right back in with just a click of a button. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.